Today, we're going to discuss about the class Osteocytes in subphylum Vertebrata, in phylum Chordata, in kingdom Animalia. Last class, we have seen Chondrocytes in the subphylum Vertebrata. And today, we're going to see the class Osteocytes. Osteo means bone in Greek. And cytes, cytes means fish. So, osteo means bone. In which language? In Greek, osteo means bone. And ichthyosis is fish. So, this class contains bony fishes. It includes both marine and freshwater fishes with bony endoskeleton and spindle-shaped body. So, the habitat may be marine and freshwater fishes. And they have bony endoskeleton. That is, inside it, it possesses bony endoskeleton. And the body is spindle-shaped. So, like this, the spindle shape, no? They're like this, the shape of the fish, you know, no? Like that. Spindle shape. And the skin is covered by ganoid, cycloid, or tenoid scales. So, here on the upper surface, you have like this, no? You will draw like this only, no? That scales are ganoid, cycloid or tenoid scales. And the respiration is by four pairs of filamentous gills. So here, chondritis, you have studied about lamelliform gills. But here it has four pairs of filamentous gills and it is covered by an operculum on either side. So it is got protected. That is, the gills is covered by a operculum. But in chondritis, it is absent. The operculum is absent. Air blade is present with or without a connection to the gut. So the air bladder. So the bladder which is seen in the gills, after the gills, that may be present or not present. And it is not connected with the gut. So the air bladder will be seen with gut or without gut. So, it got connected with the gut or not gut, with or without gut. It helps in gaseous exchanges and for maintaining buoyancy in most of the finned fishes. So, this air bladder helps in gaseous exchange in lung fishes. And it also maintains the buoyancy, means the floating in ray finned fishes, the floating function. It helps in floating. Buoyancy means floating in the ray-finned fishes. They have a ventrally placed two-chamber heart. So, their heart is two-chambered. And excretory organs are mesonephric kidneys, amniotelic, that is the nitrogen waste. Here it is excreted as ammonia. So, the excretory organs are mesonephric and or amniotelic. So, the presence of well-developed lateral line sense organs. So, they have lateral lines, lateral line sense organs. So, the sense organs are, so you can see the sense organs are seen in this lateral side, that is side. By the sides, they will see, you can see the sense organs. And the sexes are separate and the fertilization is external. It leaves the egg and the sperm, the fertilization fusion takes place outside the body, not inside the body. Such type of fertilization is called external fertilization. Oviparous means egg laying. From the egg only, it lays the eggs and the eggs maturity, after that the young ones will be hatched from the eggs. So, such type it is called as oviparous. Examples of osteocytes: Exocetus, flying fish; Hippocamus, seahorse; Labio, rohu, the tastiest fish; Katla, you know very well, Katla fish; Echinus, sucker fish; Pterophyllum, angel fish. That you have seen in this angel fish, you have seen in most of the fish tanks, you are allowed to watch it, no? So, this is flying fish. It is called the flying fish. You can see the fins. It looks like a bird, no? And it is a seahorse. That is seahorse. And this is the angel fish. This you have seen in fish tanks. and this is crab. Crab means kendamine, and it is sucker fish. So these are the examples of osteocytes. Hope you understand the topic. If you have any doubts, post your doubts in the comment box. If you want to watch the video in Tamil, I had given the link in the description box. You can go and watch it. Give a thumbs up, share and subscribe to Science Easy Tech channel.